Hello everybody, Kyle here from Web Dev Simplified. This video is going to be a bit different than my usual tutorial style videos, because instead of teaching you a specific topic, I'm going to teach you how to learn about any topic that you're interested in. These are the steps that I personally use, as well as many people that I know use in order to learn new technologies, frameworks, or languages, and it works incredibly well for me, and hopefully will work well for you also. So, without any further ado, let's get started. The first step that you need to take is to actually research the topic that you want to learn. This can be done through articles, podcasts, or video format, but I prefer to use videos and podcasts because I can actually speed up the audio quicker than if I was reading an article, for example, because I can listen much quicker than I can read. And also, these videos and podcasts and articles should not be tutorial-based. They should be purely informational so that you can learn about what this technology is, why you should use it, and a little bit about how it works, but not really how you should implement it. The goal of this research is so that by the time you're done with the research, you can explain what this concept or technology or language or framework is to someone in a way that would make them understand it. And so that means that you actually have a fairly deep understanding of what the idea is, even if you don't know how to use this idea. Another goal of this research is that by the end of it, you should have a pretty solid understanding of the pros and cons of using this certain language or topic or framework. And also, you should know of any libraries or frameworks that are popular and helpful in using this actual language. So for Node.js, a very popular framework is Express. So you should know about the existence of this framework so that you can possibly learn it later in your learning experience for learning Node.js. The next thing you're going to want to do is actually start to learn about how you can use this certain topic and how it works. And to do that, you need to go in and read the documentation. But you don't need to go into the nitty-gritty of the documentation. Almost every language, framework, or topic has a getting started or introduction section in their documentation that you should familiarize yourself with so that you can read through it and have a basic understanding of how you would set up a project of this magnitude. You may also want to read documentation on how to install anything that you need installed on your computer in order to start working with this language or framework. And the entire idea of learning about how to set up an application is so that you can do part 3, which is to create a Hello World application. Now, depending on what you're learning, this Hello World application may be a bit different, but in general, a Hello World application is just a very small application, the smallest size possible, that allows you to use this language or framework. So for a Node.js application, this would essentially just be a server that you create that prints out something to the screen. Usually the text Hello World is what people like to use when creating this first Hello World style application. This shouldn't be a very hard task to do, but as you run into problems, you can Google tutorials or instructional videos or anything like that, look through the documentation in order to figure out how to get past these roadblocks that you encounter in your learning process. This idea of the Hello World application is to get you just the basic understanding of how to get something working, and then that way you can add onto it without having the extra problems of trying to get it working and adding onto it at the same exact time. The fourth thing that you need to do is to actually build a small application around this idea. So for Node.js, you would build a very small Node.js application. It is also really important that you make sure that this small application includes nothing else that's new to you other than what you're trying to learn. If you're trying to learn Node.js, for example, don't try to throw in a bunch of extra things such as a React framework on the front end of this small application if you don't already know React. And even if you do know React, you probably don't need it for this small application that you're building, since the emphasis is on learning Node.js. So anything else that's not related to what you're trying to learn, keep to an absolute minimum and spend the least amount of time that you can on it in order to build this application. And one last thing about this fourth step of building a small application is don't skip the Hello World application. You may think that, well, this small application is really not too much bigger than a Hello World, and Hello Worlds are boring, so I'm just going to skip that. But please don't do that. The Hello World application really helps you get started and figure out how to actually use this technology in the smallest way possible, which in the long run will save you so much more time than you spend actually working on that Hello World application. Because in reality, the Hello World application shouldn't take you very long, so you're really not wasting much time, but you're learning so much in that small amount of time. The next step is going to be dependent on what you're learning, but then is to create another small application, and possibly even the exact same small application, but to use some popular frameworks or libraries inside of that application. So for Node.js, for example, Express is one of the most popular frameworks that you can be using for a Node.js application, and almost nobody creates Node.js applications without some form of framework to help make it easier. So in this fifth step, it would be to take that small application you already built, or build another similar small application, but use that framework or library such as Express to help make your learning process easier and the building of the application easier. This will help you understand a more real-world sense of how this technology works, since instead of just using basic Node, which almost no one does for building web applications, you'll be building it with Express, which is extremely popular, and tons of people in across all different industries will be using Express and Node together. This will also allow you to see the pros and cons of this actual framework, because if you're building a very similar or the same application, you'll see where it's easier and where it's harder with using that framework. And it's important to make sure you do this framework part after you've actually built the original application, because you don't want to try to learn a framework and the topic that you're trying to learn at the same time, because it'll just make your learning experience much harder than it needs to be. And now we're at the final step, which is to build the application that you wanted to learn this topic for in the first place. So for example, if you're learning Node.js, maybe you wanted to learn Node.js because you wanted to create a new API for some kind of application that you're running. So now you can go ahead and build that API using Node.js, which you just learned. It'll be a difficult task because while you don't have a ton of experience with this new topic that you've learned, you're going to run into a lot of roadblocks. And during this last step, you're going to be referencing lots of articles and tutorials for the many different roadblocks that you run into. I also recommend on the smaller applications that you build to constantly reference different documentation and tutorials on the things that you get stuck on, because you are going to get stuck on tons of things, so having those resources available will help make you go through roadblocks so much quicker. Just make sure that you're not just following a tutorial for the entire application. You want to build as much of these applications by yourself so that you can actually go through the learning process and thinking process and problem solving process on your own without relying on someone else doing the work for you. That's why I only use the tutorials when I get stuck on something and I can use them to break through whatever roadblock I'm encountering. Also, if you are learning the technology but don't have an idea for an end goal project that you want to learn it for, just create any application that's a little bit bigger than a small application and maybe incorporates a few extra things that you wouldn't incorporate in the small application. For example, maybe a database or a React frontend to an application if you're learning Node.js on the backend. This will allow you to see how the different parts interact together and give you a better understanding of how to use what you're trying to learn overall. And that's really all it takes to learn a new topic. By the time you finish building this medium-sized or larger application, you're going to have a fairly solid understanding of this topic and be able to use it in future projects with no problem. I would recommend, though, in your learning process, to spend more time in the first few steps of researching and reading documentation, because having a strong understanding of what you're actually learning before you try to start learning it and implementing it will make the implementation process so much easier and make it easier to figure out where you should be using this technology as opposed to other technologies in place of it. So I really hope you guys learned something in this video about how you can actually apply different techniques to learn new topics quicker and more efficiently. If you guys enjoyed the video, please make sure to subscribe to my channel for tutorials that may help you in your learning process of certain technologies. Also, let me know down in the comments below what you are trying to learn, and I may be able to create tutorial videos about these different topics if they're popular enough. So, with that, thank you guys very much for watching, and have a good day.